Right now at 10, in just hours, the Economic Development Commission will be accepting proposals to redevelop the former Southside Library.
And Governor Evers approves a plan sending millions of dollars for health care services in the Chippewa Valley, but not before using his partial veto power.
Plus, the nationwide pilot shortage is affecting the La Crosse Regional Airport.
Watching WKBT La Crosse, this is News 8 Now at 10.
Good evening, everyone, and thanks for joining us for News 8 Now at 10. I'm Ken Kozarowski.
And I'm Emily Brown.
Governor Evers has used his partial veto power to sign a plan allowing $15 million in state money to support health care services in the Chippewa Valley. Now, late last week, the legislature approved two bills to address the impending HSHS and Purveya closure crisis. One bill allowed $15 million to support emergency room capital expenditures in Eau Claire and Chippewa counties. The other bill simply moved the money from an unspent account into the state's general fund to let that happen. The governor today vetoed the first bill and then used a line item veto in the second bill to allow the money to be spent on, quote, any hospital services meeting the area's pressing health care access needs. Now, in a release, Evers echoed Eau Claire Democrats who argued limiting the money to emergency room capital expenses didn't offer enough flexibility for the area's needs. Western Wisconsin Republicans criticized the line item veto, saying the governor has effectively created a slush fund that only further delays critical funds for the area. Now, the Republican-controlled Joint Finance Committee still has the final say here because it has the authority to actually release that $15 million.
Residents are hoping to see the Southside Library redeveloped soon. Starting tomorrow, the La Crosse Economic and Community Development Commission will be accepting proposals. News 8 Now's Jeremy Wall has this story. Jeremy.
Well, Emily, the library closed in April and has been vacant since then due to reduced cost. Earlier, I spoke to Andrea Train with the city, who says daycares, nonprofits, and residential developments have expressed interest in redeveloping this property. Neighbors I spoke to say they would love to see more housing and also a community center. Eric Schell has lived nearby the library for years. He says there's a variety of projects he would love to see, including more housing and green space.
Single dwelling homes probably fit into the neighborhood the best. As far as green space, we have a park behind it. It's really being utilized by the neighborhood. Parents and kids are there constantly.
On Thursday, La Crosse's Economic and Community Development Commission will begin accepting proposals. According to Train, the property is open for almost anything. Train says she definitely would like to see more housing.
We have a huge lack of housing. I understand that there are a lot of developments going on right now that are residential. However, we will still need to continue additional residential development.
The half-acre parcel will start at $348,000. Train says it can be turned into a whole residential development or a mixed-use one. Residents, including Mary Sullivan, hope someone will buy it and redevelop the library into a community center.
We have one on this part of town, but it's a ways away.
Other residents, like Deanna Neubauer, want to see something that will benefit seniors.
We're looking for places where people can find social time and maybe a meal. So, if it was large enough for that.
But they'll have to wait a couple of months to see what gets proposed. Now, the deadline to accept proposals is April 17th. The proposals will then be presented to the ECDC on April 24th. Live in La Crosse, Jeremy Wall, News 8 Now.
All right, thank you, Jeremy. Anyone making a proposal for the property can contact Andrea Train directly, and we will have her info on all of our digital platforms.
Airports across the nation and in La Crosse have been experiencing a pilot shortage. This has caused many airlines to pull out from regional airports. This month, La Crosse Regional Airport announced that Delta Airlines would be leaving, but they will be adding a new flight from American Airlines in April. According to airport officials, 42 regional airports have lost service from airline carriers, an issue they're hopeful will turn around. The aviation industry needs 13,000 pilots a year, but as of late, they've only seen those numbers reach 6,500. American Airlines will be adding a new flight each day to Chicago to provide more connectivity for passengers. They'll be upgrading their aircraft, which will provide more seating options for passengers.
Currently, we are served by a 50-seat CRJ-200 aircraft. We're going to be going to an E-175, which has, depending on configuration, about 76 passengers, and also offers dual class, so first class passengers and things like that can book seats on there.
Roberts says that there is still a large demand for flying in La Crosse. He adds it is something they will have to prove to other airlines to gain their interest. La Crosse Regional Airport officials say they plan on adding Delta back or an additional airline from a different carrier, but that time frame is still unknown.
All right, so for all of you who enjoy winter, you had a day.
Yes.
You had a day.
Hope you enjoyed it. Because it's going away tomorrow. Let's get the latest.
I like winter, so it's dear to my heart that we had winter here for one day. But you're right, it is going to be gone tomorrow. You'll wake up pretty chilly, but beyond that, it's going to be warm for probably the next 4 to 5 days. So overall, outside right now, we're still looking at temperatures. Pretty much, this is more typical of what you'd probably see in February, a little bit colder than normal, but still a lot more typical than we've seen in the past several weeks. Overall, there's your current temperatures. We're already in the single digits, and of course, those cold areas, the bogs like the Black River Falls and Sparta, they actually could approach zero or below briefly overnight just because of the conditions right now. Current observed highs, once again, well below average, what you would expect this time of year. We should be around the mid-30s, so for once, we're on the other side, 10 to 15 below average instead of 25 to 30 above. There is a warm front that's going to be approaching. That will increase the winds tomorrow and will help increase the temperatures once again. Waking up tomorrow morning on leap day, you're looking at temperatures rising to the mid-40s. Notice that wind starting to increase. The wind chill, not so much a factor going on tomorrow morning. Same with Eau Claire, probably down into the single digits. Once again, get up to the mid-30s with that south wind increasing too, and the temperatures will climb further up. So once again, get the spring gear back out because we're only going to climb further up, not just on leap day, but beyond the first weeks of March too. It looks like it's going to be warm, so it's coming back.
Love to hear it. Thank you, Greg. Well, a mild winter has led to an early tapping season for local maple farmers, and it's causing a big dip in syrup production. Bree Breckel and Eric Wenninger of Embark Maple say the early tapping season was hard to prepare for. Usually they start tapping in early March and the season runs through the end of April. But this year they started at the beginning of February and say they're already getting close to the end of tapping season. And that means the team will have less sap to work with.
We've collected around 20,000 gallons of sap so far this year, and for us, that's about 1/4 to 1/5 of what we would get in a normal year.
It marks a tough year for maple farming, but for a season that was full of unexpected warmth, there is one thing they can still guarantee: a delicious batch of maple syrup. Well, maple syrup isn't the only thing being affected by this out of ordinary winter. Despite it being only February, Helene's Hilltop Orchard in Merrill is already pruning its apple trees.
That's a first for the operation as they deal with this unusual winter season. Nolan Bowman has more on the story.
For a century-old family business, 2024 has delivered a unique opportunity for Helene's Hilltop Orchard.
We have never pruned apple trees without snow in February. So that was definitely really interesting. Never got the snowshoes out once this year for pruning.
The orchard's owner, Olivia Telsho, says the unusual weather has thrown off their regular routine, but she isn't concerned about their future crop.
The truth of the matter is that apple trees require so many chilling hours. So that's a temperature that's below 32 degrees. That's what keeps them dormant. They're naturally programmed to work that way.
However, if the thermostat is turned up for too long, then concerns will begin to grow.
We don't want a week of 80 degrees. And we've seen that before in March back in 2012, and that does cause damage.
But for now, they'll continue to remain positive and soak up the sun.
It's just been really nice to get out in this nice weather, take some long walks, walk our property, and really, I feel like we're kind of ahead of the game now.
The owner says the warmer weather is helping them look forward to events that they'll be having down the road.
The Supreme Court says it'll decide whether former President Trump is immune from federal criminal prosecution.
The High Court weighs whether his actions leading up to and on January 6th could be tried.
It's the last week for voting for Best of La Crosse County, and the votes are very close. Log on to bestoflacrossecounty.com and vote for your favorites. Voting ends on February 29th, and winners will be announced on April 1st.
This is Ford Truck Month. With amazing offers across an amazing lineup of Ford trucks, make way for the event that only comes around once a year, featuring the new 2024 Ford F-150 and Super Duty, the North American Truck of the Year. Get ready and get to Ford Truck Month. Now get 1.9% financing for 72 months, plus up to $2,000 in total savings on a 2023 Ford F-150 XLT, only at your local Northland Ford dealers.
If replacement windows, a new patio door, or a new entry door is on your 2024 home improvement list, then you owe it to yourself to connect during the 2024 Early Bird Home Show, only at the Board Store. Visit our showroom and see all of the beautiful window styles. See the beautiful new woodwork you can enjoy on your new windows. Arrange for a prompt free estimate during the 2024 Early Bird Home Show at the Board Store. Call or visit today.
It's the last week for voting for Best of La Crosse County, and the votes are very close. Log on to bestoflacrossecounty.com and vote for your favorites. Voting ends on February 29th, and winners will be announced on April 1st.
The Supreme Court has agreed to decide whether former President Donald Trump can be prosecuted on charges that he interfered with the 2020 election.
Trump has claimed he's entitled to absolute immunity because he was president then. A lower court has rejected that. CBS News correspondent Skylar Henry reports from Washington.
In its order, the Supreme Court said it will consider, quote, whether and if so, to what extent does a former president enjoy presidential immunity from criminal prosecution for conduct alleged to involve official acts during his tenure in office.
They're asking a fairly straightforward question. Does a president enjoy absolute immunity from criminal prosecution based on official acts?
The decision delays a trial involving former President Donald Trump's efforts to overturn the 2020 election. In a statement, Trump welcomed the news, saying in part that without presidential immunity, quote, presidents will always be concerned and even paralyzed by the prospect of wrongful prosecution and retaliation after they leave office. The high court will hear arguments the week of April 22nd. With the decision likely no later than the end of June. So far, lower courts have rejected Trump's argument that former presidents enjoy absolute immunity for actions that fall within their official job duties.
I expect that they will uphold what the D.C. Circuit said. That was a detailed 57-page opinion. They really went through all of the former president's arguments, specifically the argument that trying him would violate the separation of powers.
Trump faces four felony charges, including conspiracy and obstruction, for allegedly plotting a scheme to defy voters and hold on to power. Skylar Henry, CBS News, Washington.
If the Supreme Court rules against Trump, it could set up a trial for later this year before the 2024 election.
Well, if you own a Jeep, you may be at risk of crashing.
A new recall has identified a problem with the front suspension.
And we're leaping right back to spring on Leap Day as the temperatures climb right back up into the 50s. In fact, we got 60s, even 70s coming up this weekend. I'll time all that out and show on. We might actually see some showers or storms coming up on your first morning weather update after the break.
Cracks in brick, cracks in block. Call American Waterworks. Leaning or bowing basement walls? Call American Waterworks. Sticking windows or doors? Call American Waterworks. Settling or sinking foundation? That's right. Call American Waterworks. It's a fact. Foundation problems don't get better with time, but they do get better when you call American Waterworks. Call American Waterworks today.
There's no telling what's in store with Wisconsin Lottery Scratch Games. It's paradise. In this $5 game, if the total for any one roll equals 7, you win the corresponding prize. You could also win double or 5 times the prize, up to $50,000. Instant Scratch Games from the Wisconsin Lottery. Odds are you'll like them.
Whether you are looking for a lake home, a second home, or your first home, let Town & Country Housing introduce you to quality living in our factory-built homes. Town & Country Housing has homes that will meet your style and budget. Tour our model homes to see how spacious and grand living can be when you let us reinvent your space. Our homes are built with energy efficiency in mind and environmentally friendly products. You pick your dream home, and we take care of the rest. Your dream home is waiting. Come personalize your amenities and start living your best life. Town & Country Housing, Chippewa Falls.
There's never been a better time to switch to Spectrum. Spectrum Internet offers speed and reliability, while advanced Wi-Fi gives you best-in-class security for all your connected devices. And Spectrum Mobile delivers unlimited talk, text, and data with nationwide 5G included. Switch now and get Spectrum Internet for $49.99, plus advanced Wi-Fi and one Spectrum Mobile Unlimited line free for 12 months. Start saving today. Visit Spectrum.com, a Spectrum store, or scan to call now.
Proper installation of your new windows make a difference. The team at Clear Choice Window and Home Solutions are factory trained to make sure your windows are installed to last. Call or stop into the showroom for your free estimate.
Thank you for watching News 8 Now. Expect more.
Chrysler is recalling more than 338,000 Jeep Grand Cherokees.
This because of the potential risk of losing control of the vehicle. The affected SUVs are all from the 2021 through 2023 model years. Parts of the front suspension could become loose, causing the front wheel to fall outward and resulting in a loss of control.
If you've got one of those affected vehicles, you may notice unusual noises while going over bumps. The company says it's not aware of any crashes or injuries resulting from this issue.
Well, it was a nice sunny and cold day, but the winds have subsided.
Thank goodness.
And it looks like we have milder temps ahead of us. Greg, let's toss it to him for the latest.
Yeah, we definitely got mild temperatures once again coming right back. Winter was only about 24 hours, then we're going to have the warmer conditions come. So like I said, tomorrow 40s, 50s, 50s, 60s, definitely by Friday. And then this weekend, 60s and even 70s. Could be Saturday or both days, Saturday and Sunday. Sunday definitely looks to be the warmest day we've had so far. With records possible, definitely Saturday and Sunday, even maybe Friday. Next week, we're going to cool down a little bit. I don't see a drop like we saw this previous week with a front coming through, but we will have a front coming through probably Sunday night or early Monday. Precipitation, winds wise, we do have some elevated fire concerns here for the next several days because we're still very dry. The winds will be picking up as the temperature starts rising. So somewhat of concern there. The winds will continue this weekend. And as I mentioned, we have that front coming through or a system coming through Sunday night and Monday night. Right now, the chances are for some showers and thunderstorms. A lot of timing issues on that and whether we'll get enough moisture to come up to actually give us some of those showers and thunderstorms a little bit in question too. But for tomorrow, really, as you wake up and go through about noon, we're looking at temperatures getting up to about the mid-30s. We're going to have a warm front that's going to lift north, and that will start increasing the winds, especially during the afternoon hours and further west of the area. Tomorrow evening should be warmer. The winds will continue. Temperatures kind of climbing back down to the 30s, so it will be a warmer Thursday evening than we've had. Going into Friday morning, definitely we're going to see warmer conditions, more like the mid-30s, low 30s as you wake up with that south wind continuing. And then in the afternoon, that south wind will continue, boosting those temperatures likely because we're going to start off warmer into the 50s to maybe 60s for a lot of the areas. So Friday evening looks very nice. Windy, breezy conditions, but warmer than we've had the last couple nights. So that's the good news. If you've got any activities going on, should be absolutely fine. Winds-wise, to mention, 10 to 15 in the morning. By the afternoon hours, we're going to see winds probably getting into the 15 to 20. As you go further into Iowa, elevation-wise, it'll probably be a little bit stronger, and further south, stronger too as you go into the afternoon hours, but it'll be from the south. So once again, that'll be a little warmer wind than we've had from the north. Friday, similar story. We're going to see those winds probably increase a little bit stronger in the afternoon, getting to that 15 to 20, maybe 20 to 25. So 2 days of winds. The problem with that wind as we go on, and we mentioned, is the fire risk because of the dry or dormant fuels that are in there and the dry conditions at the surface right now. So there is a fire threat tomorrow, mainly in Iowa, but we could see some elevated conditions tomorrow afternoon as it approaches our areas. Those relative humidities could get as low as maybe 30% in the afternoon. Once again, so be cautious if it's burning outside because these conditions could continue on Friday and Saturday. The other story is the records. Here's the records for Friday. I think Eau Claire might hit it too. We got records going on for Saturday, mid-60s, potentially another record being broken for both locations Saturday. And then Sunday definitely looks like a slam dunk with some of these locations getting record highs. Could be smashing that as both areas could get into the 70s. So once again, 3 days of records. But for tonight, one last chilly night probably with teens. Single digits, some of the colder spots probably could even get below zero briefly overnight before the winds turn around from the south. Tomorrow, warmer, winds picking up in the afternoon, still very dry, but we'll get up into the low 50s most locations, low 40s as you go further north. And then we're going to warm that back up for Friday in the upper 50s, 60s, and then once again 70s as we get towards Sunday. And questions regarding how that thunderstorm chance will work out Sunday into Monday. It may be a very short time we're going to see some rain chances, but otherwise going into the next week we'll cool back down, but we're not going to see any significant drop like we saw this week. So back to kind of April-like conditions again, too. So if you didn't like winter, spring and summer's back.
All right. Thanks, Greg. Coming up next in sports, Winona State men's basketball tipping off conference tournament time tonight, plus a few of our Minnesota high school teams looking for wins in their playoff openers. Rob is next.
This Thursday, on Leap Day, earn a 29-cent Hy-Vee fuel saver for every $29 you spend. That's a 29-cent fuel saver for every $29. This Thursday, on Leap Day, only at Hy-Vee.
Discover new opportunities together in a new Chevy. Meet up in an award-winning Equinox. Lend a hand in the Silverado with up to 14 available camera views. Or mix it up in the Trax with an 11-inch diagonal display screen. Find the Chevy that's right for you. Get 2.9% financing on all Silverado 1500 models. Or get $5,000 total cash allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle.
Visit hometownchevy.com.
It's time to vote for Best of La Crosse County. Pick your favorites in each category now through all of February. We'll announce all of the winners on April 1st. Vote for this business today on bestoflacrossecounty.com.
Presented by River Valley Remodelers.
Holman on Alaska and La Crosse. Cordell's Automotive is now even easier to find near you. Which location will you visit? Being family owned, we get what it takes to truly care for your vehicle the same way you care for those you love. Schedule an appointment and let us help you know you're safe.
I'm a martial artist, a skydiver, a pilot, and all of them require your feet to work. Get up in the morning and it felt like I was standing on marbles on my heel. When I went into the Goodfeet store, the fitting was personalized. It was all about me. You put in the arch supports and your day becomes better and the sun shines, the unicorns run by, and you know, it's a good life. I'm Randy and that's my Goodfeet story.
See for yourself with a free personalized arch support fitting at the Goodfeet store.
This Thursday, on Leap Day, earn a 29-cent Hy-Vee fuel saver for every $29 you spend. That's a 29-cent fuel saver for every $29. This Thursday, on Leap Day, only at Hy-Vee.
The exciting action from your community. Here's News 8 Now's Rob Schiff.
Playoff high school hoops taking center stage this week, and a few of our Minnesota high schools. We're tipping off the postseason tonight. We'll start in Class 2A. Let's go to the Mayo Civic Center in Rochester. The Caledonia girls taking on Lake City in the quarterfinals. First half, Josie Foster driving past the defender to the hoop. She goes off the glass for two. Warriors with the early lead. More from the Warriors. Foster passes to Nicole Bansi in the corner. The sophomore, good from three. Caledonia up five. Lots of black and gold players scoring tonight. Aubrey King gets a look from beyond the arc. Count this one. Warriors extend their lead. Caledonia just getting started. Foster again with the rock, this time from NBA range. Still good. Caledonia cruises to the win, 60-39. In Class 1A, Rushford Peterson in Rochester tonight taking on Grand Meadow. Late first half, Trojans' Nadia Happel controlling the top of the key, then controlling down the lane for the finger roll. Rush Pete up 11. Later, Cassandra Boyum on the receiving end of a pass in the lane. She quickly puts it up for two. Trojans staying in control. More from RP. Ellie Eckern kicks the ball out to a wide open Nevaeh Happel. The junior gets the shot to drop. Rush Pete up 14. Later in the half, Boyum the assist this time, hitting Torin Schneider. She cuts to the hoop. Rushford Peterson goes up 18. Trojans are moving on as they get the win, 57-38. Let's go to Class 3A. Winona Senior tipping off the postseason at home, taking on Northfield. This one all Windhawks. Second half, Adriana Brennigan gets the bucket to fall. Winona goes up by a dozen, and the home team adding to it. Later in the half, Mackenzie Simmons loses it, gets it back. The senior's going to take it all the way to the cup. Pretty finish off the glass. Lead up to 17. Then it's Olivia Bell finding Shea Berlin Burns down low for the score. Windhawks running away with this one, and they weren't done. Again, it's Bell getting fancy, this time dishing it off to Simmons for the finish. Tough bucket off the window puts Winona up 21. And then on the break, Faith Quinn finds Bell ahead of the pack. Count the bucket plus the foul. Bell lands hard, but the freshman would walk off on her own power. Windhawks walk away with the win, 62-46. Well, earlier today at Central High School, six Riverhawks making their next chapter official. We'll start on the gridiron. A senior, Antoine Hardy, is headed to Mission Viejo, California to play football at Saddleback College. Two athletes will be staying right here in La Crosse. Kate Heiderscheidt will spend her time on the pitch at UWL, while Alex Wagner signs his letter of intent to join the Eagles track team. Devin Wilkerson is heading to Stevens Point as the senior plans on playing soccer for the Pointers. Ruby Gerhardt is headed to Luther College in Decorah, Iowa to play volleyball for the Norse. And last but surely not least, Leo Orlikowski will join the Blue Golds track team at UW-Eau Claire. Congrats and good luck to all six of these student athletes. To some college action, Winona State hosting Northern State in the NSIC tournament. First half, WSU looking for some early offense off the inbounds pass. Connor Dillon, good from the corner. Warriors trail by two. Winona State starting to find their groove, though. Brock Voigt passes, gets it back, throws down the two-handed slam. We're tied. WSU starts rolling. Connor Drew doesn't like the look from the outside. Goes right to the rack for two. Warriors keep battling. Then later, Winona State offense getting in gear. Drew again from the outside of the arc. This time he takes it. That gets the student section all fired up. WSU gets its first 20-win season in a decade as they take it 95-65. Pro ball. T-Wolves at home tonight looking for their third straight win, taking on the Grizzlies. Memphis up 9 in the third, but Minnesota making a run. Anthony Edwards skies high for the slam. Then later it's Ant-Man again straight to the cup. And in the fourth, we have liftoff. Edwards throws it down again, and the Wolves start pulling away. Naz Reid this time, he joins the dunk fest. T-Wolves make it three straight as they get the win 110-101. So a fun night of basketball at all levels.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Fun and stuff out there.
And I got to say, those T-Wolves jerseys are really, really sweet.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it.
They are gorgeous.
Good stuff.
All right.
Okay.
Local, national, you got it,
we have it all,
as always. Thanks, Rob.
All right. We'll be right back after this.
The model year-end clearance is going on now at Dahl Auto. We have 80 2023s in stock, and it's time for them to go. You'll get exceptional savings, plus financing as low as 0%. Hurry to Dahl Auto today.
Fresh out of Papa Murphy's kitchen, the limited-time triple pet pizza.
Actually, it's fresh out of my oven.
Dad, it's just an expression.
Giant, classic, and mini cup pepperoni? Now that is an expression.
Order the triple pep today.
If your tub or shower is less than you'd like it to be, then you owe it to yourself to visit the board store during the 2024 Early Bird Home Show. If you'd like a shower, rain shower, personal shower, shelves, safety grab bars, you can get a complete unit as low as $79.80. Call or visit the board store during the Early Bird Home Show for safety, convenience, and beauty in your new bathroom. Call or visit today.
I'm Kelly Wilde. It's 102.7 WKBH. When my grandmother passed away, my mom gifted me with her Bohemian cookbook. I found one recipe for a soup, and written on top of it in my grandmother's beautiful handwriting was, "She really loves this." So I cook up a small batch, bring it over to my mom, and she says, "What is this?" I said, "It's your favorite soup from Grandma Paulda's cookbook." Then my mom said she would make this for her dog Ginger when she couldn't go to the bathroom.
What I love about T-Mobile is that just about anywhere you go, you're going to have coverage.
Where I live is a rural area. The coverage has been awesome.
Reliable coverage is super important for me, for my business.
And after investing billions to light up our network from big cities to small towns, T-Mobile is America's largest and fastest 5G network. See for yourself. Try T-Mobile's network free for 3 months. Your phone, our network, no strings.
What?
I'm in love with whoever made this country fried steak. Can I borrow a pen?
Love letter.
Five meals for under $10. Only at Perkins.
Your car is worth more, $500 more, when you sell it to Dahl Auto. We'll give you an exceptional offer for your current vehicle, plus up to $500 over book value. Get more at Dahl Auto.
Expect more from News 8 Now. Thanks for watching.
Well, Raptor Education Group out in Anago had an eventful week after rescuing three birds.
That's right. They saved a barred owl stuck in a chimney and untangled a bald eagle and red-tailed falcon from an electric fence.
All three of those birds are now recovering and will soon be released back into the wild. Nolan Bullman has more from Anago.
The Raptor Education Group Incorporated is no stranger to receiving unusual calls, but hearing a barred owl was stuck in a chimney for 4 days in Marshfield came as quite the surprise.
He might have been going in the chimney, maybe chasing a mouse, and then found himself, you know, in a tight place and couldn't get out.
Shortly after, they were called about a bald eagle and a red-tailed falcon tangled together upside down in an electric fence in Stratford.
I really thought when I saw the photo, you know, of them upside down, you know, two very powerful raptors, that, you know, there would be really fatal injuries or serious injuries.
Despite a few scraps, each bird is recovering, a true testament of the care that Reggie provides.
My staff is amazing. I mean, they're absolutely the best in the business. We're really grateful for them.
Not to mention a big hand from law enforcement and people like you keeping a watchful eye.
We rely on the public so much, and law enforcement, who is the Marathon County Sheriff, as well as the Marshfield Police Department. Thank goodness that they're there and, you know, can help us in these situations.
Well, this was Ken's worst nightmare. He's afraid of birds, so he couldn't watch
Yeah, those large ones, man. Those close-up shots. They're beautiful, but, you know, just
Just keep them away from me.
Yeah, but glad they saved them.
I appreciate them. I take videos of them. Okay. Greg, we'll have one look at our forecast when we come back.
At Bygoff and Rohde, we know reputation is important, and it can affect your case's outcome. If you want your case to be taken seriously, you need lawyers who are taken seriously. Bygoff and Rohde, serious injuries need serious lawyers.
Did you know that when you buy from Morey's, you get Morey's Promise? Morey's will always offer you our best price first, upfront, pure and simple. And our product specialists are commission-free, so there's no haggling necessary. Our lifetime powertrain warranty on new vehicles covers your engine and transmission nationwide for life. Also, our powertrain warranty on Morey's certified pre-owned vehicles covers you for 10 years, 100,000 miles, and much, much more. Morey's, moving life forward.
So, all of us are here to talk about trading. Right now at U.S. Cellular, you can get a new phone without having to trade in your old one.
Trade you my PB&J for that phone.
No, kid, you don't have to trade. See? $830 off any phone at U.S. Cellular. No trade-in needed.
You drive a hard bargain. Boom. Chocolate milk.
You don't have to trade.
I'll take the chocolate milk.
Okay.
Boom.
Get $830 off any phone. No trade-in needed. U.S. Cellular. Built for us.
For over 40 years, La Crosse Glass and Overhead Door has been the go-to company for anything glass and door. We offer a large stock inventory of CEHI garage doors to help you find the perfect fit. As a locally owned business, we take pride in our work and always get the job done. From commercial glass and glazing to residential glass and CEHI garage doors, we have the experience and expertise to help you. Call or visit our website today.
Let River City Grill be your new lunch destination. Whether it's corporate lunches, parties, or events, we have the space and food for all of your gathering needs, big or small. We offer an all-you-can-eat lunch buffet from 11 a.m. till 2 p.m. with unlimited soup, salad, pizza, wings, and so much more. There's something for everybody. Stop by the bar and pair your delicious lunch with one of our many beers available on draft. River City Grill, Winona, Minnesota.
Is your personal injury lawyer trying to sell you a settlement that you don't think is fair? You need a lawyer who won't settle your case just to move on to the next one. Get the full compensation you deserve. Get by Goff and Rohde.
All right, after a chilly night, we're going to have milder conditions tomorrow with breezy also conditions in the afternoon. We should get in the 50s, probably La Crosse, a little bit cooler up to the north, upper 40s, but still much milder than we've had, and above average too. Otherwise, we'll see the temperatures continue to climb through the end of the week and the weekend. Looks like 70s are likely by Sunday, and maybe some showers or storms Sunday night.
Watch
out. Spring is back.
Yeah, watch out, Ken. The birds are going to be out tweeting, flying.
Oh, gosh. See you tomorrow.